This time we're going to do some drunken chicken with some more aromatics, and I'm going to add more this time. Rosemary, oregano, basil. Look, I said it right. Garlic, got some lime. I'm out of lemon, so we're going to use some lemon pepper. And we're going to put this stuff in the chicken rocket, that thing there. And I just put some oil on it. I actually sprayed some Crisco on it. We're not trying to season it. It's already seasoned. And got the chimney of charcoal fired up. Now I need to go ahead and clean the bird, get the gizzards and lizards outside, out from inside of them. And I also got a couple little country ribs, which are actually cut from the pork butt, which is not from the butt, it's actually from the shoulder part of the pig. Boy, and we're going to cook that too, and I'm only going to put wolf rub on it and cook them up. Now I was going to make a homemade cooking serve chocolate pie. I've done them before, and with a, you know, a graham cracker crust. You can also make them with a flour type crust or whatever, but I ain't got enough milk. And I always add some more semi-sweet chocolate to this pudding mix, the cooking serve. Don't use the instant junk. Makes a real good pie. And you can put you some whipped cream out of the little spray bottle on top, make it all pretty. Meat hammer. High quality cutting board. Garlic. Wooshed off Dryzack knife. Take that piece of paper off. And we ain't worried about the rest because this is just for aromatics. Bust up. You can remove some of it if you really want to. You too. Bust up. Yeah, you can get some of the papers off, but you're not gonna eat this. But just stick this in there. And we'll save a little bit to stick in the chicken's butt. Now let me wrench them herbs off and get that did. Now while our fire is lighting, we'll go ahead and put some oregano up in there with that garlic. Y'all get to know. Hey boy, y'all get to know one another. And it look like Charlie Brown Christmas tree right here, don't it? Yeah, good. Rosemary, go up in there too. Put some basil in there too. Stuff it down in there. We're building a nuclear rocket ship here. Submarines and all that kind of bullshit. Want some more rosemary? All right, y'all go in there too. Now let's grab some, let's put a little Leanne Perrin in there. Cause it got all kind of good shit in here. We're just gonna do it. Put some of that, the good stuff. Yum. Aromatics. Now, I normally don't use liquid smoke, but I'm gonna use real smoke out there on it too. But I'm gonna put some in here to get a little bit of smoke inside Mr. Chicken. And that's going to help it out on the inside. Otherwise, it wouldn't see no smoke flavor on the inside of the chicken. And we'd as soon exhaust this bottle because there ain't much left in it. Let's go ahead and put a little bit of lemon pepper in there too. Because lemon and pepper is aromatic. And that'll aid our cause. Over here, boy. Little Chevettas. Got vinegar in it. And pepper. And some garlic. And some other stuff. We're going to put some of that in there. And yeah, y'all tried to straighten me out on the wine thing. Yeah, wine is kind of aromatic. When you start cooking, it smells like burned grapes. Sorry, I ain't going there. Let's put some green onions in here. I got that. Green onions. Get in there. And all that aromatic shit. Give us some more flavor, another flavor dimension. The fifth dimension. That was a show too, wasn't it? Like the Twilight Zone. Ooh, who with the spinning wheel? Now let's stick a few lime wedges up in there. Just for the hell of it. Lemon, lime, herb, chicken. Boy, let me give me another pop. All right, now I just washed my hands with Dawn soap. And guys, don't use Gojo. It got grit in it. Don't use lava. Use dish soap. Warm water. All right, I got this chicken up in here. We need to get him out the package. Stay up in there. All you other little pieces of innards come out of that. We don't want y'all. All right, we got a cavity now. That's good. Give him a little bath. Wash under his arms. Both arms. Up around his butt. Around his leg. And on his titties. Get him clean up. All clean. And no, I ain't wearing no goddamn diaper playing drunk. Where y'all come up with that bullshit from, man? Think y'all all funny. Especially them Canadian boys. Not cuts, though. Now stick some rosemary up in there. It's all been washed. Bust it up. Stick it in there. Stick some oregano in there. Stick some more lime up in there. Yep. Get up in his ass. Go on up in there, boy. We're gonna stick some basil in there. And we're gonna put some more garlic in there. All right. We got a lot of stuff up inside that chicken's butt. It's all right. We're going to stick him on his rocket. Go down on there, I said. What? Fly away, boy. Now, let's season the outside of this breed. With some southern flavor charbroil seasoning. My buddy Wade from Alabama sent me, or brought me actually when he came down here. And that's black pepper and stuff you see. It's gonna be like black and buried. Come on your hand, JB, and rub it all over this bird's butt. On the kitties too. Let's season the shit out of it. Come around there on your little tie. You too. Down there. Now. Everybody happy. Now these have been cut with a bandsaw and they got a bone in them. You want to get them bone fragments off. You're not killing no germs. You're not doing any stupid shit like that. You're just getting the bone fragments off. Go ahead and wrench all of them. Like you see me doing. Come on, hurry up, boy. Got all goddamn day here. We're gonna get some wolf rub. And no, I ain't gonna give you the recipe free. Larry's a friend of mine. You go pay him $25 and get the recipe. Down here. Sprinkle the wolf rub on them liberally. And it got sugar in it, so it's gonna brown and caramelize somewhat. Just don't put no tomato sauce based stuff on there yet. You do that in the last 20 minutes of cooking if you want a glaze. I think I'm gonna go ahead and hit them with a little bit of this southern flavor too while I'm at it. For the heck of it, because it tastes pretty damn good. Give them another flavor dimension. Go check on our grill. Right here, Mel. See, the coals are ready. All you gotta do is brush this puppy dog down. Come on, get clean, boy. Oh. Okay. So how am I gonna get them charcoals down in there? You don't grab that, that's is hot. Better pick it up with some damn channel lock, boy. Now. Gotta find some wood. Here, Wood. I know where you're at. Stand by, boy. Alrighty. Let's get our chicken on here. Put it back there. We're gonna put them chops right there. And right there. And right there. Close this dog down. You can go rinse your hands off in the zinc. Now, before y'all start asking questions, I want y'all to look at the other comments. Your question may have already been answered on all my videos. So please read all the comments. And there may be more than one page. Most of them have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, well, depends on the video. Yeah, this is convertible. I've shut the gas off and I only used it to clean the grill and to light the chimney with. And now we're cooking with charcoal and hickory wood. Okay? Now the chicken is going to have to go for a while until I get my instant read and hit the thigh area. And it reads, I think 170. And being as it's got that rocket up its butt, it's going to keep the breast kind of moist. This is going to be good. We're going to have some baked beans. I'm out of Allen's, but I got some Bush's homestyle. And I got some potato salad that I bought at the store at the deli, so I ain't got a with it. Boy, can y'all look at the wall for a little while? See, look, bricks. Oh, mortar in the joints. Smoke that. Just another brick in the wall. Come on, get your kids. So we're cooking at about 400 down, but it's probably 350 grate. Look, here you go. And I like this one best with the bamboo. I made some hamburgers last night on the Charbroil charcoal gas combination grill. But I didn't make a video of it because may have been the pops. We just leave it like that. They come out good though. I think I made a partial video of it. I may post it at some prank. We'll see. I'm gonna get me a gun and kill all the whiteys I see. I see a white dog. The back entrance to JB place. See what it say there? And I mean that too. Now I just nuked down some margarine. And look down on the bottom here. See that? See that clear liquid down here? See this clear liquid down here? That's water. salted water. The stuff up here is butter-flavored grease. Yum, huh? All right, I got some fresh from the deli hamburger buns. They come unsliced. You gotta slice them your damn self. This is what your restaurants do. You delis and grills. They take this this oil mixture, and without disturbing the water, they put that grease on top. Just the grease, not the water. Kind of like clarified butter, which you can do yourself too. We're just going to use this because I melted it down to show you fine people out there in YouTube land. And we're going to go put these on the grill. That chicken just about ready to eat. Amazing, huh? All right, there that chicken is. Now we got to cut it. That's why I don't like buying whole chicken pieces. You gotta trim it. Yeah, right. Cut in half, son of a bitch. And there's all that rosemary and all that good stuff up inside. Move out the way, boy. Look like there's one leg quarter. There's a breast section right there. And here the other half. I'm kind of falling apart. Let's get this other leg quarter off. If you want, you can go ahead and cut the wang off. Well, we just eat it like that. What the hell? Put all this grass stuff on top. Yum. Just like that there. I'm gonna tell you what, that's the best part, right, Chip? Give me all of that. So here we go. I look marvelous. I feel marvelous. There's so many country ribs. And they are marvelous. And there's some grilled bread. And it's marvelous. Now here's some marvelous baked beans. Fresh out the damn can. And there's that chicken. And it looks marvelous. Yum. See that? Like that there. Marvelous. With all this green stuff. Now I got this potato salad I got from the deli. So I ain't had to make it. And it's marvelous. Yeah. Somebody mentioned something about the man cave. The wet bar up in there. Beer steins all at the top. Old memorabilia wall of fame from the band days. dartboard, keyboard, playing a little demo, little pub table. These guys here, and I think we got R2 down there too. Yeah, he is. Got a TNT, bass amp with a Squire, a little Ibanez guitar amp. And look, JB got his EL wire lit up on his drums. We got all kind of junk in here. This is a computer that I built. It's clear, see-through, and let me see if I can change the mode on the blinking feets. Yeah, there they go. They blink and do all kind of weird shit. One of my daughter's lights. Just some other crap. Old Victorian lamp. And over the steam engines, there's a lava lamp back there. I don't have it on. Old Technics 100 watt for real channel power amp. Everything works. The tape deck works. It's old Sony. These are TX right here. These are Technics. There's a Technics turntable. It's direct drive. It works. Old Sony 8-track recorder. It works. What is that? Look like magic mushroom. Those the kid loved that when they was coming up. Not the mushroom, the picture. And then this boy here, he'll follow you. And just got all kind of old cool shit in here. Look, a real old-timey dial telephone. And it works. I ain't shitting you. One of them plasma bulbs back there. The Three Stooges, I don't know if it's plugged in. Yeah, it's plugged in. And there's a motion lamp in there. It's got all kind of memorabilia. There's a mug from Germany up top. I don't know if you can see it. So this is the room. Got monitor speakers in here. There's some JBL full range cabinets. Old mixing board. I got new TX stuff. 18-inch JBL subs. There's four of them in here all together. It's all kind of cool stuff. Y'all can shut up now over there, boy. And back here in the back, we got just a bunch of old toys that I collect from when I was a kid. Look, who remembers? Let's see if you can see it. The old radiometer turns on the light. That's some more JBL cabinets right there, tucked in. Cool, huh? See, it's all clear. You can see the inner workings and motherboard. And I built that. How about that? Amazing. There's a strobe light and a black light. And just other little toys and things up there. Memorabilia stuff. My daughter's Fender Electric Acoustic. This nice sounding guitar. It's been a hard day night. We also got a one of them moving lights. You gotta play music loud for it to pick it up, and it'll make patterns all over the damn room. Cool, huh? Oh yeah, Brunswick pool table too. Close that. Blues Brothers.
EL wire, electroluminous wire that you can buy online. It comes in different colors. Notice all the medals that I got doing solo and ensemble festival when I was in high school. A real old-timey school desk. Amazing, huh? Rocket science. Okay, these are JBL 4311B studio monitors. They're badass. This is a JBL. It's got a 15 and a slot tweeter in it. This is JB about 15 years ago on a hydro slide behind my ski boat. Husqvarna 610 WERX badass big boy bike.